strength. That is what the Lord is looking for from us and from all those who believe in God. Glory and strength must come out of our lives. Testimony of glory. Testimony of strength. Hallelujah. That our lives must reveal and reflect before God who is mighty and before God who is the I am that I am. Give unto the Lord glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness. And since the Lord Jesus has become to us holiness, then the spirit of holiness is in us. And we can give to the Lord in the spirit and the beauty of holiness. For Christ to us is also holiness. So sacrifice again, you're going to be blood. But here I would like to say in verse 3, and we talk, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. He will bring his word to fulfillment or fruition in our lives. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful, and the voice of the Lord is full of majesty. Hallelujah. Now you look at this plantation, a company program, a kind of name, it was a hard day. You may have a newspaper, you may have a man, a kind of they are not like what the Bible describes of the voice of God. And this very description is, I believe, to every one of us, is the type of voice that you and me and the whole world needs to hear and listen to. All other voices, you got no kind of characteristics blown in by. This one defines the voice of God. So before I preach, I would like to lay a platform here so that when I speak, that voice of God, which I now read from Psalms 29, will come to you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Have faith in God. Believe in Jesus Christ. Verse 5, let me talk again of the voice of God, and the voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. You know what kind of you are? You got a quilana, you got a hundred and a while, sometimes you got a kumarena, you got a mangrove grono, Nandi Salipati, you got dry, or a nail blue, you might have a good side, even though you're really strong too. So these are some of the hard wood that we have. Cedars are like, why? They are hard wood. And we have protruna, strength, strong, some of man will travel, penetrate in this black place. You will need some extra, strong, strong. Look, cracking kind, something was there. That's what Bible let me talk. The voice of the Lord. That means that the voice of the Lord is stronger than the strongest.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So sitting here, let's have confidence in God and his voice, regardless of where we are and what we are going through. It might seem like you are in a sinner kind of an experience, but church, let me ask you, trust the voice of God and let the voice of the Lord squeeze that cedar in your life and my life, so that there's going to be a highway created for you and me to walk into glory today.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Let me talk. Yes, the Lord splinters the cedars of Lebanon. And only you got you also sit on under the mountain strand now, rocky hills and roadblocks and go China. Finally, they get nominal wall stone stuff, you go, Dari Dari, you go, all this stuff, a holy stone, and sit down, and they grow so tall now. All two go strong, that are now. That's a battle talk, that voice blow, God, he cry, and we can book him on even go around a book him on half a book it up. So you can look somewhere, know how powerful the voice of God is. So trust in big man, and look at God. All kinds of voices going through my mind today, but I would rather welcome your voice that splits the cedars. If cedar is a strong tree, then let me say, tighty women, the rocky women, the foundation, the tighty little stone, the neck where you can cry, the booty baby will hop up. Me like in this land, neck, you cry, the baby, and whatever, there's something you holding me, and we need your Lord, and then the booty will hop up too. Morning on the day. Amen. And God good blood on me blood. Say this time, Mr. Bandana, we need to sleep in my heart like a mother in me. Natural wind can see me go around and can go slit us or because and we got good la roots and make it again and some again a position wrong end. That's a neck long God, you can book him in the house in the place problem. The voice of God can split it and even displace it. And such is the power and the grace that the voice of God carries. So, church and believers in Christ, let's have confidence in God's voice.
Yes.
I know many other voices are speaking. Whisper despair, doubt, discouragement, giving up, frustrations, or whatever. I mean, all kinds of situations in life we go through. But this line here, some of the descriptions that the writer of Psalms 29, and he painting the UV, so that when we read, at least we get an understanding of the voice of God, and in his way, you begin a lighting light from people, position it right, so that when we go before God, we know that when he speaks, something can happen. And we don't, and we stop under the plenty water, talk to the plenty water. The power to confirm the word lies again in the same voice that speaks the word. It's the voice of God. Line 62, he makes them skip like a calf. Hallelujah. And bring him exuberant, how much he can make, restoring joy. Something that is a sign of life that seems to be fading away from us, but skip for joy is a sign of breakthrough, is a sign of hope, and it's a sign that you are getting healed and getting delivered, and whatever is troubling you is over, and you are going over, getting over this thing, and you are walking into freedom.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Skip like a calf, Lebanon and Syrian like a wild ox. Wild ox are the is an untamed and raw strength and raw energy and raw potential and everything that is raw that God is competing you and me. The voice of God can quicken them with this raw and you can sit down and find yourself again in the beauty of God's voice.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We Amen. Have the privilege. We as believers in Christ have the privilege for the voice of God is always found in the house of God.
Amen.
Why not? It's untamed. Potential not yet fully explored. But the voice of God can reach deep down into those unexplored areas and places that you and me don't know even of ourselves that God has already affected. And the moment the voice of God addresses those areas, you will look over you and go, wow, man, I thought I can never be there or do that, but my God, now I can see, I can be there, I can do that. How am I? Because the voice of God make you skip like a calf and like a wild ox. There is raw energy coming out of you.
Wow. Yes, yes, yes. Amen.
You have potential. The house of God is not a weak house. We are full of power because the voice that is stronger than the strongest is in you and me, for we have his spirit.
Amen.
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 Negro newspaper, Negro corruption, Negro decay, Negro all kinds of negative things that are going, Negro fear. Listen, they don't do anything good like what we're reading in Psalms 29. So, the voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. You think if that means you grab in wilderness, you say, I'm going to hope. Let's try to make it time, make it better, and make it more. I'm second, second, make it more fatal. It's affecting the state of that prisoner. Being in a wilderness state is going to now be transformed to become a fertile place.
Oh, yes.
So you might seem like in a wilderness state of life, or you look and say, oh, something dry now, or something you've been in the middle of a negro, better do and be finished now, yeah, but I mean, finish on the eye. That's a lot of negro going to cry, and I've been turning to the ground, you look dry. Now, when you come a fertile again.
Amen.
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 And fertile soil is a highly valuable soil. Almost I grease law, good blood ground and because some of them grease pull up from him now. You don't need to plant something, you put your seed that's on because ground got grease finish and you got power log and power in seed and good blood harvest can come. That body affecting wilderness, you saw you become fertile, and good harvest is on the way for you. Amen? A rich God harvest. God measure of the harvest. It's coming your way. It's not an enemy type of enemy level measure, but it's a God measure. Why? Because on earth you are in the wilderness state, but when the sovereign voice of of God from heaven comes and affects the state of the every state of life, you must know the measure of God is not coming upon you now. Something different is going to come your way and my way. Amen.
Amen.
The voice of the Lord makes the deer gives birth. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, you know, we got an hour or something, but for whatever reasons, maybe you got something like delay start now. I'm not carrying. We don't know to do nothing, or being just good Christians. No, we don't know to do. You got to impact your life, believe me now. Bringing a positive change to society, community, and the nation as well. But this is the voice of God. The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth and strips the forest bare. God, anything that seems to be in the wild now. And he hide in the hill upon the evening was in, you know, a road because of the rock nearly blocking you. The neck will go carry me the stripping forest pain where there seems to be no way now, but you look at come up the skin and a place where tribal bush and a rock near the hang and barret is stopped. You know, look at the road there. The neck carry a road come up the place where it seems like no rock may come up the place where it seems like no rock may come up on it. The voice of the Lord can give that opportunity and create that for us. Hallelujah. Voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth, strips the forest bare, and in his temple, everyone says, glory. Hallelujah. No shame, no worry, not giving up, no heavy heaviness, not going to give up. No one. In the house of the Lord, everybody in the house of the Lord, the tune of every believer in the Lord's house, knowing who has an understanding of the voice of God, we must be shouting glory. Mask in or film, but you like sing out glory. And house of God, now something different can happen. So just out glory. Now let the voice of God do something.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hey, you believe, my name is God. Amen. I like this. I'm for every introduction. That's all. I'm going to the message for today. The Lord set a throne at the flood. Bible something. And the Lord sits as king forever. No one will be displaced him. As long as you can be making him king of heaven, middle of peace. Whenever I spirit no good, no devil, no tamaran, no situation, but displacing kingship, blame, no life, you and me. And the Bible says, be king forever. Nobody can displace him. As long as Arnold says, God, you king, will life, me. He's king forever. I know come on, no, tomorrow I'm going to be, baby. Struggle to find him a king. God, like I'm a king forever, no life, no one, man. As long as you make him become a king, for him is, to God's understanding, a way of him looking at him being king to in each one of us. He says, forever. Forever reign, forever rule as king. You know, temporary. Come now, but tomorrow, and next Sunday, come. Tomorrow, maybe I say, now you go on another king, or money, or something. Sunday, then come a king. No, God, it's a forever thing. Time may change, but everlasting doesn't change. God is a forever king.
Amen.
The Lord will give strength to his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Amen. Well, sister, one bell. Amen. Over the one bell.
One bell.
All right, because if you want to be alone, I'll be priest.
Amen.
Amen. We are going to know some of our final instructions for Jesus Christ. And they're important to us. We are living in the last of the last days and the last hour. Amen. With reference to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
We will live the last hour. And in Gregorian calendar, might say January to December, and we are calculating is 2021, and next year by Gregory is 2022. But by God, God is not Gregory. God is God, and Gregory is Gregory. So calendar that belongs to Gregory, it belongs to Gregory, but God's own is called timing too. And the church of the Lord, once we are in sync with the voice of the Lord, we can understand spiritual frequencies and we can also discern the right seasons of God, where we are right now, according to the calendar of God himself.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. So we are living our final hours, the final time, so some are living today. Prior to Jesus going onto the cross of Calvary, he collected his disciples together and I'm starting to talk long also. I see that it's also important for us to listen to the same instructions. All right? Same instructions. Where Jesus is talking to the disciples from him. Me feeling what's going to be important to you as a church of Jesus Christ today, that we have to go through this and look at it once more for our own benefit as well, because there is always a gain in the word of the Lord. For whenever and wherever we go through and we come face to face with the word of God, the word never fails. For the Bible says it is forever settled in the heavens, and all the promises of God are yea and amen. That means that the word of God always produces good results.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why nobody is sitting here this morning coming face to face with the word of God, you're wasting your time.
True.
Because the word of God is not wasting its time.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
You are coming face to face with a word that proves itself to be true.
Yes.
It doesn't need any backup of anything outside of itself. No. It has all the latent power to bring itself to fulfillment and confirming itself. Whatever it says, the word has the ability to confirm whatever it says. It doesn't need the external support or whatever. That's why we need to pull ourselves up and align ourselves together with the word. Because there is so much in the word that God can, through his word, bring about in our lives. And whatever we anticipate to see or we plan, if I look at come up on life from people, talk for what he can deliver the human. Amen. In John chapter 14, there is a story blow, spirit blow big man. Believe and love of God. And these are some instructions that I'm going to touch this morning. And I pray in the name of Jesus that God, as I've said, now me, talk about reading Psalms 29, that voice will address our heart. The state of heart that each one of us has. Bible is talking about Jeremiah that the heart is deceitful above all things.
True.
Who can know it?
True.
I'm challenged by you here. You know all the money can bear, but God in measuring bear not all gets deceitful above all things.
Yes, yes.
All things include our mind.
Yes, subconscious.
All things include our feelings, yes. Our emotions, our present state, our future, our past, whatever it is, all comes as all things. It's deceitful above them all.
True.
But God is greater than men's heart.
Amen.
And the Bible says he is the one that judges men's heart. The time that he judges him, and he said, bring in fairness. He judges accurately. And God's judgment is always on spot, on time, and accurate. According to his best wisdom, he delivers accurate judgment. So that when he does that, rich benefits and people shall receive. And I pray this morning that the Lord will help us. Amen. John 14, right? John 14. Verses 15 to 31. It's a good, quite long reading. There's a Genesis 1 and also James 1 and all this. We'll go through this morning, so. Amen. We pray God will talk to me. Just look through us and be pastor and be.
Yes, Lord.
Something is their fading glory, all things are fading glory. But God alone, his glory doesn't fade. It's an ever increasing glory.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
True blood. If that glory affects your life, that means your life is gonna get better because it's gonna ever increase under that glory, because that glory is an ever increasing one. The moment the glory touches your life and my life, it will always make your life and my life get better because it is an ever-increasing glory.
Yes, Lord. True.
It is a better glory.
Yes, Lord.
The glory of the Father from my house is a fading, passing away glory. All things that we see in the nature are temporary, and they have a fading glory. They're going to die, and they're subject to corruption, decay, and death. But the glory of the Lord never fades. Why? Because it doesn't die. Amen. Now, me black have this love privilege that being one with Jesus Christ, we are affected by the glory. And that's why we shall live forever. Amen. You and me will not die. We shall live forever. Hey, you must have more.
True.
Jesus.
Amen.
All right, verse 15, let me. We are going to read some instructions for the pleasure. And some things that I wrote down, and some blood by me writing, but I'm just preaching as it comes out of my spirit. Okay, it begins this way. you love me, keep my commands. And as it says, bro, true, brother.
True.
It's not just hard talk. No, it's actually doing it that shows that we love you.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
You can be good church after this, after the sorrow, and whatever. But when I look at this, my meet of God, power of heaven, talk blue and clear, straightforward. As we look down a bit further, because a lot of few other scriptures of passages put out on this lap, and we're making repetition, bro, is the same talk. And why repetition? Because it's important. That's why the one who was teaching, whilst those who were listening, must grasp that important thing. That is the reason why Jesus was repeating himself, because he knows the inability of men not to retain information.
True.
Because men, when we fell into sin, it affects even our minds and memory. That's why no man is perfect except God. Sin has affected us so much so that people come here has a clear understanding about the effects of sin in human lives. So when he was speaking, he never spoke from the place of being ignorant and blind to the effect of sin. He knows that we were affected by sin. So when he was addressing the people, he knew that they were weak. Therefore, when he places an emphasis on something, he knows the importance of the thing, and he also knows about the state of man's weakness. So he must confront the issue, the weakness of man, from the place of strength, and at the same time, in consideration of what is important, that needs to be delivered to those whom he loves, but yet in a place of weakness. So the important thing is repetition, in order to see them from the place of their weakness to come into the place where they now can retain what is important to them as God sees. Amen. Hallelujah. Our church is not just come maybe good Sundays and have an open sermon for this time and then we forget about it and come for another revelation the next Sunday and then forget about it. Listen, there is a rebuke you go to Timothy and Beethoven said, in the last days people will have itchy ears. They'll be drawn just to hear the latest, but they will not be disciplined to really put the word to practice.
True.
And we are entering such seasons like this, and I pray that this church, we will not be like those ones who are going to be having itchy ears, but we will be those ones who will apply the word to express before God our love for him and for him. Amen. If you love me, keep my commandments. That's straightforward. You know, brother, don't appreciate it. You love me, don't be a little hungry. I'm sorry, don't come past. Or send now, you be now, it's by choice that we have to choose to obey. Now we have to listen to his instructions. As God freely gave his word to us, we receive freely of the word of the Lord from God. Now we have to rise up by loving him, or showing that we love him. Keep his word. Do his word. Do what it says. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Every day, every minute, every double of God, make him. Give him that, give him. Give him offering, give him.
True.
Amen. Look at that. No good thing was supposed to have the Bible, and I must have the Bible. Because we read the Bible, and you're scared.
True, yeah.
We read him the Bible, Papa. Good. I mean, I have to really check myself too. Amen. So we talk, we man, yeah, pastor, but man, and man. True. I'm not superhuman. My father, Mr. We love him too. God bless us, but by grace, God sustains us. Every one of us. Amen. We might have our weaknesses, but God is always good. Hallelujah. All right. And talk about big money. The essence of love is to keep the commands of God. Maybe we're going to verse 12, 15, 16. And I will pray the Father. Because when you keep the commands, it opens up and positions you and me in the right place, then now the Holy Spirit can come and work with us. It's not just carrying Bible around. The Holy Spirit is coming to those who now who have the word and is doing the Father's will, or being in top of God, please him, Papa, you like him and you send him, like him, you la Papa, and he give him gift the Spirit. Give the Spirit in the nothing. In a way, I mean, you can look and say, Bel Hamasta Papaya. You like it, you're a gift, and you give spirit from you. And I stop under you. You know, man, no carrying this like a soul, no bad, no line, no behind him, no bar, no this la. Spirit, no big man, because then to any spirit, no talk, he will come for the word, and he will come with those who said behind him now. Make it talk, no more. that, hey, Papa God, this land nice, yeah. Because we place a better than the Papa God. Some Holy Spirit blow you, come on me. Oh, put my baby mother spirit blow you. Be like him, spirit blow you. Go talk to them. Kiss it, talk to me. So I like him blow you, no me, but be him, talk to me, the spirit blow you, they come on this side. You be him, talk to the spirit, you come. Amen.
Amen.
I mean, Bible talk, there is no shortcut into the treasure of the house of the Father. Still wants a gun on the window. So don't adopt this style of the people like, there is still a shortcut for that. Oh, Lord, you get some of this, you get my place now. Miss a lot of me, Miss a Panina, Miss a Pastana, Miss a Kanya. But it's not going to work that way. We have to go by the door. Door simply means that there are principles that God has given him now. Say, oh, that will talk to God. And you may have to talk to God. Give me no heart for something. Amen. Now, we talk. When we do that, verse 16, we talk. And I will pray. And he, the Father, will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. Because you love me. That's Lord, expressing your love, you be in command of me. Me be sending Holy Spirit on top of this blood. Where you should say you like me because you love me. The Spirit will be sent to that person. Who keeps the word.
True, true.
The comfort of the Spirit will come upon us who love God and who do His will, His commands. Amen. Now listen, let me not come temporarily that He may abide with you forever. God's idea is permanent value. This is divine idea. Man's idea may be, we're going to be feeling pastime. And then we go, no got feeling, we go, we go, not the place, the body, the feeling. God talk, feminine dwelling. Jesus.
True.
How God is from where he is. I mean, the, you know, as we go to land hearts, that was the original idea. Amen? That God be with us forever. That was the original idea. Sin come, it's telling that God do the sin and the stealing the money. I deal with you. I'll punish you, and I'll give you pain, and I'll give you pain. I'll plan that will blow me, but still hope you. Amen. And I will pray the Father, he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. He will abide with the one who's keeping the commands forever. As long as we continue to keep the word of God, the Spirit will never leave us. Amen. He will always be with us. Now, you know, Spirit, there is no one plus Spirit, nothing, nothing. And Spirit of God. And spiritual anointing, and spiritual power, and spiritual grace, and spiritual mercy, and spiritual goodness, and spiritual order, something that is of God. Now, for him being dead to dwell with us forever, I am Papa God. The thing that we must do is to obey the word, just do the word of God. That will give that opportunity for the Holy Spirit to dwell with us and abide with us forever. And whatever he will do. True to us. People are by, you know, now the Sunday, I want the people to go where you feel me. Over a day, I'm normal, you here. On one panel, you are normal, you are normal, forever normal. I'm stuck on the new year. On one panel, you are normal, you are normal, you are forever normal. Because God hasn't changed, so. As long as I'm stuck on the new, you will be changed into him who doesn't change now. His state of being will affect us, and his unchangeability will affect us and make us conform to his state. Eventually, in that place, we're going to get perfect in God. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot see, whom the world cannot receive. It's impossible for them because how can they receive the Spirit of God? Because who do know? You know what life is at the world? The Spirit of God is dead and it's off. They are cut off from the source of life, God, so they can't receive it. Because the world neither sees him. Listen, the Bible says the world doesn't see the Holy Spirit. Whatever spirit they are seeing is not the Holy Spirit. Because the Bible says the world doesn't see him. But those who keep the word and those who do the word, you receive him.
Amen.
And you also see him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. There is a clear line drawn here. There is a clear demarcation line drawn here. That the world don't see him, they don't receive him either. But you and me who believes in God, who keeps the word of God, we receive him and we also see him. And in your high spirit, by you being looking at. Amen. God in And listen, we have spiritual eyes that can see God. The Bible says, eyes that you can see, ears you have, and heart to perceive the good things of God. God has placed us, seated us from the place of darkness and death and sin and blindness into the place that we now have in Christ, the ability to see. And the first thing that we can see by their grace and ability is to see God, the one who opens eyes, before we can see other things. So when we see God and we see other things, we will now interpret everything in life from the reference point of God that we see first. For he being the Alpha and the Omega is the one that we see first, and he defines any other thing from his own reference point. Amen. Hallelujah. See you, blood, powerful line here. Jesus bless you, blood.
Amen.
I'm a man of God. Me, true blood. God used to matter me forever. Amen.
Hey,
you see the intent of God, Lord. The Holy Spirit is with us forever. You know, Christmas convention, you come and push it or whatever. Forever means forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Forever is not limited to time. It's an eternal attachment that God comes to me, at least to you, and stay there with you forever. Time is a change, season is a Spirit of God, let's come under you forever. Oh, my God.
True, true.
Bien itu melakukan apa yang saya minta pelan di badan dan bapa kau sali boleh spirit lebih kiri dan mila bin feel feel lah rel. Bien itu nampak na ini start na poro forever. Orman badan start na you are you mungkin tengah ibu apa perlu saya. And then you carry me go na you pick the life dan alamannya ke badan start. I mean it does happen that way. And if people are praying, but there is impression from others. Because those who are with God now can affect other lives. Amen. It's easy. Yeah. And you see, I mean, Christ Jesus. Spirit of God come in on us, man. Stop at the natural, pro, you know, Calvary, pro, all the way to glory. My God, such poro. Amen. Now you look at the prayer, man. Amen. The Holy Spirit, meaning anything,
Amen.
Become just like natural. It's normal. It's a daily experience. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Hey, just find the word and do the word, and it saves us our prayer as well. Amen.
Amen.
Just doing the word. It's not, it's just practically doing what the word says. What the translation is telling us.
Remember what I told you.
Only all the translations.
Do.
Amen. I'm just sorry. Me looking right now, saying, "Victor, don't let me look at you. Don't let me look at you." I feel that it offers me a road, because when you talk about road, man, me the God Almighty show me a way forward. Because these are the days of the supernatural, and these are the last hours. God, you know, I was here to this message because prior to Jesus, he was approaching the cross. And this chapter 14 is a reference to the cross that he's going to go there to make preparation. Lord, making preparation. Lord, dwelling, Lord, and we talk about this verse 1 and 2. Go down. And with the, where I am, there you shall be also. Because when he went to the cross of Calvary, he paved the way for people to be with him. So, after this point, I'm you control your life, when I bring a breakthrough for you, what you must do now, after the death of the cross, and you come into relationship with God on a daily basis, your requirement and what you must do is to keep the word so that my spirit now will be with you forever. You know, church, you got plenty of spirit. Spirit with devil, sangkuma masalah si corona, delta, meta, nawas the latest one, Omicron. Omicron. Anyway, all the Italian names only. Corona is Italian, Omicron is Italian, Sigi Grab China, Nemlo, Sigan Gamma Italy, Manfani Gamma America, all the world is going around circles. But listen to me, hallelujah. Those who live by the word of the Lord, the Spirit of the Lord shall be with you.
Amen.
Amen. People are not needing Omicron, people are not needing Delta, people are not. I mean, these things are real. They are affecting humanity today. But the word of God, the Bible says, never change. That's why I will speak with boldness from this. For my confidence comes from God and from the word. Because the word doesn't change. That's why I have my confidence to speak to the church. This word will change situation, not any other word. And I will pray the Father. No one will be better than Jesus Christ, Papa New Sahara. Listen, Jesus is the one to pray. You need to pray. That's what I'm saying. You say he pray for you. You want to say to pray for Jesus. Look at Papa Sahara Moga that because and pray for him. And some of pray now. Pray and yet. Now you don't let pray for Papa. You think the Papa you don't have that I pray for Jesus Christ. My God. So same prayer, Holy Spirit must have you forever. You think it was a prayer when I was. Now you know every Papa to before you end it, you end it, please. Spirit, go hurry up before the prayer is finished. Because the Father, Son, and the Spirit is one. Whenever the Son does come up in the carnage to pray, he's praying in the will of the Father because he's one with the Father. He's actually getting back to where the Father is and he's praying from the place to where we are.
Amen.
And the Spirit also is with them, he knows. If the Spirit is to appreciate the Son, he may walk from him. So God is executing and fulfilling his own prayer. We are the recipients of that prayer. And how? And how we must live is to live by the word. So the prayer of Jesus will continue to be fulfilled in our lives. To have his spirit be with us forever. Amen. He may abide with you forever. I like that one because it defeats time. It goes beyond Sunday, Monday, Pune, Trine, Gold Lamoon. Forever means forever. Forever time will start. And go now. Amen? So forever will start, not too many years will finish. Forever has never changed. Time says that forever will start, one day, meaning forever. You can understand this conversation. The spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive. It's totally impossible. So don't go to Orwalia and look up Orwalia. You now we have access. The world don't have access to the Holy Spirit. We have an advantage for this bracket size. When the world cannot receive, that you can receive. Hey, you are in a better position. Jesus, my God. We live in the world, but we are not of the world. We are not like the world. We are different. We are a church of the living God. We are born again and filled with the Spirit. We are the one that keeps the word and do the word. And the Spirit of the living God abides with us forever.
Amen.
We are not like the world. Publicity one guy, I'm alright, that's all. You may begin in the past. The spirit of truth which the world cannot receive. My God. I don't care how much they do. Certain spiritual intelligence and dimensions of information and wisdom is unlocked through the Spirit of God only. Men may attain to certain level of intelligence and information, worldly with worldly wisdom and intelligence. But to actually get to the level of the Spirit's wisdom, it's impossible. Because the world cannot receive him, they cannot receive his dimensions of levels of wisdom and understanding, it's not by no God. But you and me, we are in the position to receive. We have that advantage.
Amen.
There's a brilliant God. The spiritual intelligence is accessible to the church of God.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. The world cannot receive because it neither sees him. And who's going to talk to that company? They're going to see him. You can bring him a little more close to Now God moved. It's totally impossible because they are dead, they cannot see him. They are accused. Bolivar, I mean, even today on Facebook, the world do not even care about pastors. On Venezuela, pastor, cursing Pablo God. But I mean, it's all printed on Facebook wall. I mean, all of you, you saw the Facebook people looking. There's no more fear because they don't receive, they don't see the Holy Spirit. So how could they interact with God? How could they speak his language? How could they speak his wisdom? How could they express any love of God? Impossible!
True, true.
They are dead!
Come now.
But we have the advantages. We can see the Spirit. As he begins to release his wisdom, you will see him. Hallelujah! You will see him in your night hours. You will see him in your day hours. You will see him behind your wheels driving to whatever locations that you are heading to, or destinations that you are heading to. You can see him behind your wheels. You can see him while walking. You can see him while conversing with another person. God can speak to you. You see the Spirit beyond all the person that is going through, so that you can address the situation from the standpoint of the Spirit of God. Such grace. When we see him, you are not looking on the Spirit. You are in seeing the Spirit. You are seeing who he is, what he is, what he can do. The ability of God, the moves of God, the language of God, the revelations of God, and all that is of the Spirit. In seeing him, you will see him as he is, the Bible says. You're not looking kind of half up, but you're going to see him as he is in fullness. For God gives a Spirit without measure. It's the totality of the Spirit God pours upon you and me. And in your ability to see, you're going to see it in that measure as God gives. Now we get to give him goosebumps, it's more than goosebumps. Shadow gives, encouraging him, walking on water, praying on limited things, and the limited things that touches your hand begin to multiply. It beats the normal things of life. Normal way of thinking. How can something, and you know, bread, fish, it's already limited, it's dead. So people are letting you go. A few more hours, some people stay, and it's not going to be good for eating. Because it's not become poisonous to the body. But the moment it touches the man who has the Spirit of the living God, who sees the Spirit and who receives the Spirit, some supernatural hand of God affects that which is subject to decay and corruption, and it can quicken it so that he can now lengthen his time of life, so that now he can become a benefit not only for one small boy, but for 5,000 extra.
Amen.
That is the supernatural ability of God that comes by the Spirit, where the church can see and the church receives as well. Those who obey the word. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord, whom the world cannot see and receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be with you in you forever. Amen. Thank God for the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Church, we can talk. It's now time to get closer to the Holy Spirit. Yes. Honestly. If time permits, I'll get us all the way to Genesis chapter 1, and I'll get us to Psalms 110, that it speaks about the scepter of the Lord's strength. That's the Holy Spirit of the resurrection, that you can execute judgment on kings.
Oh, yes.
That's power and capacity for those who have the Spirit that dwells and abides with them forever. We have that.
Yes.
But why we are not performing in such level is simply because of lack of knowledge. We don't know. That's why, let's get back to the Bible and allow the Spirit that dwells and lives in us forever begin to enlighten our minds and heart with the information from heaven, the knowledge of God's word.
Yeah, also do the word of God too.
Amen.
Amen.
For he dwells with you and will be with you forever. Am I dear living man? Am I not going to feel good as all now? Look at him, let us stop. Whether you be feeling or you be not feeling, but God is, let me stop. And let dwell with us. Amen. That is the idea that God has for each and every one of us individually, family, context, at the same time as a corporate house, as a church of Jesus. Verse 9, in a little while longer, the world will see me no more, but you will see me. I like that. Go to Remlani. And even Jesus, he talked, one will not see me, but you will still see me. Even though in my physical absence, God has the ability, even though he's in the physical, he's not present, he's still present. that speaks about the reference to the Spirit of God. I may depart, but I shall still be with you. When you get back, you go down to protect Bro. Genesis, maybe a Mr. Bro here, and I will go all the way back to Genesis, and maybe I'll touch later. About Adam and Eve and how God interacted with him. And he created what is called an Eden. And Eden is, means the presence of the Lord. So he created a spot where the presence of God that is in the heavens, where God is, on earth. Eden is the spot in which the same presence in heaven is contained. It's there. Mm. And he put man in that presence. Amen. One can similarly in the New Testament, I will go, my presence physically will depart, but my presence like Eden may start for that. Now one can see something in the body and me go, yeah. But me, something get presence from spirit to come to you. So that like the old way Eden was, here the spirit is, so the presence will not leave you. I depart, but the presence will not leave you. Amen. So the idea of God is a big idea for men. That our dwelling place every day must be in the presence of God. Hallelujah. So when I say that, church, please grasp this important thing. That we must learn to cultivate the presence of God at all times. Amen? How do we do that? Worship. How do we do that? Do your Rabbah Shanda. How do you do that? Get into the Word of God. Take the Word, read the Bible, speak the Word of God. Any and every other thing that we do will not build the presence of God. It is by spiritual exercises of prayer, fasting, the word, meditating, prophetic decrees and declarations. When we do that, we cultivate the presence, and the presence will become to us our dwelling on earth. Amen. I will not leave you as orphans. Orphans don't have no cover, no provisions, no supply, so that you will have confidence of security and comfort. And supply of your sustaining, to sustain your life. And often you are cut off. You are not connected to a supply source. You are left alone so that you depend on your own ability. And you have, if you have enough or I have enough, then depending on that strength, you live and I live. But here God says, I will cut that off. No offsetting, no offering spirit will come to you. I cut off so that I become a provision for your continuity.
Oh, yes.
Even though you are left on earth, you can still live. Eternity is still here. Time is here. Time and not disallowed. But often it's like cutting off so that from time, you connect directly to the eternal grace. Amen. Hallelujah. God defeats your feelings for us. But somebody's offense, you don't have provisions. You don't have supply. You don't have security. You live in fear. You live in want. And you live in uncertainty. You don't know what tomorrow holds for you. Somebody who's an orphan, you don't have confidence. You lack your confidence because you don't have fire.
True.
You don't have money.
True.
So they're killing you. Why not? Nothing. Carry nothing. Nothing. Sick. They're killing you. Nothing. Nothing. But Jesus said to me, "Because I'm not telling you, because I will make sure you stay under cover. Provision, supply, comfort, healing, hope, everything. When I cut the offense from you, I make you connected to me. And because God is an eternal supplier who never ceases and who never changes, you will have an eternal and everlasting continual supply of all that life will need." Amen. The spirit of truth in the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. Thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit. Amen. And a little while longer, and the world will see me no more. But you will see me because I live. You also will live. Amen. So, church, you're not going to die. You will live. Those who believe in Jesus, those who love God by doing his commands and who receive the Spirit, and because we do the word of God and the bidding of God's word, the Spirit is abiding with us forever. We are not dying. We are living forever with God. Amen. Amen. Suppose you exit this physical life and then you go, you're still not going to die. But you like on the side, but you like coming alive, you go, I mean, that's what a highway of holiness provides for us. That you have access between heaven and earth, is it? That's what a highway of holiness does for us. Nothing obstructs your pathway of going to heaven in and out, no. And it's a frequent thing. Anytime you like go, drawing more better, so it's like, yeah, amen, according to all the promises of God's living word. Amen. Verse 20, at the day you will know that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me and I in you. He who has my commands, now listen to me, that's what I started earlier, repetition here. God is repeating me, lo yumi, lo yumi, can grasp the importance, lo keep him top of the big man. That's it. I've looked for a key to maintaining presence, lo God, continually with me. If we can go down that lane and align with the word of God and do the word of God practically, practically, what we know from the word, we just do that. Whether mind doesn't like him or feelings like him, feelings will not deliver us. It is God who is the deliverer. Amen. Let's do the word of God. So that as we do the word of God, God will be with us. Verse 21, and he who has my commands, it's not just any commands of the Lord, and keeps them. Many of us, we have the commands. We carry, good Bible says, all the commands, 66 books full of commands. But it's actually doing the commands of God, doing the will of God that opens the floodgates of the heavens. You know, the Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3,
it's a recipe for success right there.
God says eternity in the heart of man.
Don't just do it. Don't just
hear. Eternity is in God. Time is here on earth. But also eternity is here. But he has set that eternity in the heart of man. And I was looking into open heaven. If we want to go out the open heaven into the eternity of God, let that eternity, the heart become open to God, it will trigger up and open heaven over your life.
Oh yes.
And how do we get that open? We tune to the frequency of the word of God by lining our lives according to the commands of the living word. It busts open the heavens, and the eternity in the heavens get connected to the eternity of the heart that is open to God, who is eternal. Go put him eternity in the heart. Amen. That's why it makes you and me an eternal being in God. So God sends you to that eternity and his own eternal spirit and his own eternal commands. So the eternal being, us, connected to the eternal word, now connected to the eternal spirit, to the eternal God. We might be living in time, but by eternal grace of God, we can now walk with the eternal supernatural power. Let that expression of this supernatural, eternal greatness of God find expression through the eternity that is in the heart of man. We have that place that God want to work through. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And if he who has my commands, we have it here, we have it here, we have it here. We write so many of them here. We have them, you know, on the wall.
True.
But it's not doing of it. Can't it's not body, no making only a paper, yeah. Rush the paper, not come to you. I'm seeing left hand, blow body. I'm saying, make it. I'm a blow.
I'm the sole.
We got no here. We got something in the house too. That's all you know. It's always something to make him walk. And you know, can't it's not body, not putting no place, but make it clock, yeah, and make it power.
I'm the sole.
Amen. We can line a planting moves the right the paper. Oh my god, wow. Look at that, wow. Now you wow start. That's what we are looking for free to go for me. He must go back and place for me writing. Place for me reading on me. Place for me hiring on church on me. Place for me hiring on YouTube. Place for me hiring on Facebook. Or WhatsApp. Telegram. TikTok. When I go down, it's not TikTok. You go talk. There's one leg goes that way, stick, another goes that way, spot. This way, stick, off, tick, off, tick. I don't know how they turn that thing. I'm going to hold it. He who has my commands and keeps them, it is he who loves me. It's a proof that we love God. Amen.
True, yeah. Go and forgive that brother. Physically doing it, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Command is not fast and prayer, yes, that is all that.
things as well, like mercy and faith and grace and kindness and goodness and honestness and something is that we do all those things that the word of the Lord says. It's a key that opens up and you gain access literally to
success.
All that is of God.
Yes.
The power of God. I mean, I hear the word. I must hear Mr. Christian Life Lumina. I mean, I boast about being a pastor like a number of years and being in a church like this and I mean, not just that it's light of my testimony. But look, continue is to obey the word. Continue to live by the word. All right, don't make it something complicated. You pay it as you pay it as you pay it. You go read him, now you clear, you don't clear, but you clear the English here, you make it as you you feel it, and you won't go into Philip. Lose it in the Philip, make it as you know, time, flat get him, you open, over the Philip, make it up. Amen. Philip gets up, Dinky Bella gets up to me and go, wow. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, hallelujah. When the Lord shows up, we will run out of words.
True.
When the Lord shows up, like, you know, he goes to speak, when I go, I mean, you know, I mean, God is big. God is just awesome. Amen, hallelujah. He has my commands and keeps them. It is he who loves me, and he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. He said, prepare manifestation. We want to manifest presence. Jesus, who? You manifest presence. I want feet. Go now. Go back to God now. Jesus promised me this. Me be manifesting. You make it up. Me make it up. Now manifest not a problem. You don't pray for it. I promise. Amen. Amen. Judas not discouraged, all right? That the disciples said to him, Lord, I wish that you will manifest yourself to us and not to the world. Jesus said, look, if anyone loves me, keep my word. And my Father will love him, and I will come to him and make our home with him. I like that. You know, if you didn't know a house in heaven, now Jesus didn't know you come to a house in heaven. You like to mention you sleep in heaven, I go to heaven. Before you got to mention to you, me like you, yeah, come to a house with me. No, ground past that. But I'm going to mention to you about even stop. Ground there, we can pass there. Only come from Milan, we can make him house room inside of you now. We stop inside of you. No ground. Before I, that you like a motor, and me too, I mean like one of them.
That's where Jesus was operating from.
No, you mean like, other than go, you go. Light there, atom, ground there, like atom. Be like, Jesus, don't give me a command, we can go house.
So, and you recall there's a kind of house called God, yeah, inside of
him. So, which house are you looking for? When he's saying that you are the house here, and I'm the house here. Amen. Nice. And we will come and we will make our home. House is another thing. Home is another thing altogether. I'm straight our moms. Also, talk with the papa, you can make your house. Mama, time when you go to the house, become a home. So, spend plan, mattress, we start decoration on the side. How you come, Lord, door, now you must open it. This is like a style. Sleep up, you must on the side, and the lady must step in the same. That's a design of a home. There's a certain, you know, principles for how do you go in. Papa, you come and pull you, and mama giving me that kind of sense. Now, time you pay the top of God, as a God comes to the land to you, you got up money, you come up house, you come up home. It's a dwelling place of God. And dwelling place of God, he just not dwell in any kind of, he dwells in a house that is built according to his own standards. It's meeting to him, it's satisfying to him, it's pleasing to him. So the moment we do that, we keep the commands by expressing our love for him, and he makes our life become his home. You are not just a house, you are a fully occupied place, a home. Dwelling place that you go to the home and you say, Master, there is an occupant there. Hallelujah. You know, empty house where people run around to and fro freedom, like Lord. No, it's an occupied place. Even people are not going to know. It's not just a house. No, it's already a home. Somebody is in there. He's occupying that place. It is not only a house, it's now a home. Amen. So people are like in kind of sin. We pray for him to come, but one important key for God to come and make his permanent dwelling and make our lives become his home on earth. You know church, you know house, you know that. There's another scripture that says that our body is the temple. But he am talking that your life, not just body, life becomes home. Body is the temple, but life becomes home. Jesus.
True.
Now you think him. You do and you like money. Now that God come up and you like my come up home from him. Where else may you go? You do, if you have now to God become a home of God, definitely you are a home to God, man. You are in a home too. You are at home.
Yes.
And being at home, you can comfort, you can rest, you can sleep with a little time for your mother. Hey, we don't really gonna be talking about. Then you go up home, it's just like bah. When the Lord makes your life become a home like this, you go, ah. You better know ya. Even in the face of a storm, Jesus was sleeping. When he makes your life and my life become a home, you can rest with confidence even in stormy weathers.
Shh. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, powerful house of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know, God has such confidence in us that he can make such statements like this.
Thank you, Jesus.
But the moment you come to know Jesus Christ, you are not that person, and you become a home of God. You are not the son of mama.
True, true.
You are not a poor person.
Yes.
You are not that beggar on the street. You are not that drop up of grade 6 that man despising you.
And
listen to me. A home is not something of whatever standard that men may use to measure you. A home is of God's standard.
Yes.
It's a dwelling place of God. It's not just a house that is not occupied. No, it's a fully occupied house that is occupied not by men, but by God himself, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
Yes.
No wonder Colossians 7 pleases the Father. According to divine wisdom, there is a fullness of the deity to dwell in a bodily form. There is a design of God, yes. Also, now, how many of you got life from God? And that life was not just a life that we like a spirit, we have a soul, and we live in our body, and one day we die, body will go to heaven, your spirit departs to heaven. No! See in the context of what the word says, a home. A home is a home of God, home for the Father and home for the Son. You don't think it was a name? You don't want to go to town, you go to town, you come up to the house for you. Ah, big la marlo, big city, ding for you. Ramro, ding ding by store, to one by penis, or mama pinga pendo, and some of them is a marlo. Because home is something to sit the mindset that automatically realizes everything of your life. Home has that grace. Home has that dimension of grace that can enable us to whatever and wherever we are, once we enter home, and you're gonna comfort here, you're gonna place for security here, you're gonna place for confidence here, you're gonna place his office in my room in the Maloya, this is we here, relax here. Then God make him also you come up, home long and I'm a Maloya, you, Maloya, you can come here and so, and then if you come up, Maloya, place for you can the Maloya, you shall be with you.
Amen. Amen.
Listen, don't love Omicron. It's a devil, it's a demon. It doesn't carry grace before our group.
True.
You must hate him. Don't love him.
True.
Fight the devil.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Fight the devil. Hate the devil. Do everything that we know and we can be able by the power of God to fight the devil and get the devil out. In Jesus' name. Amen. Verse 23, Jesus said to him, if anyone loves me, anyone is offering to everybody. CRC, GPPC, DDC, YL. Anybody, anywhere, everywhere. Anyone. Anyone means anyone. Might be black, white, African, Papua New Guinea, CP, for red or light, rich, poor, long, tall, short, illiterate, whatever. All class, as long as you are a human being. Amen? All your qualification is you are a human being. And Jesus said to him, if anyone loves me, he will keep my command. Church, the simple message I want to say to us, besides what that I've preached preach to us. Let's keep the word. Do the word, amen. Make it our duty to just do the word, practically. Just go now, talk to one, make it a solo. We might not fully understand what it says, but just do it. As long as it's in an understandable language like English, that we read and know, just do it. You might not feel it, I might not feel it, in a big English, keep on less or whatever. Anyway, because you talk. Me not feeling good, that's because you talk about me, make it a solo. Listen to me, that will trigger off a powerful will go over your life and my life. Obedience is the key. Doing the will of God opens a floodgate. Sometimes he doesn't need much prayer. It's by moving to a certain location or doing certain things or moving certain things according to the Lord's command. It's obedience with shifting. True blood God. And I know it by experience. I've been there and I know. And I know what I'm saying. Just obedience. You know better? You know what? It's just obedience. Go talk to one plus something and maybe with a few moments. Or you give him this plus something. Or you ring this like a man. Or you talk or send this plus. Or you make it. The moment you harem na, make it a soul, it opens up the floodgates. And all that God has planned to release, it will come through the gate of the one word that is released earlier. Now you not believe in the enemy and open the floodgate for the rest that God wants to give you will follow. He will have to test us first to prove that we are worthy to receive the rest. That's why he sent the first command, the alien one, the first rain, so that he makes us prepare for the latter rain. All the abundance that's going to come is still with him, but he will test us to prove that we are worthy for the rest. Amen.
Amen.
He who does not love me, verse 24, and keep my words, and the word which you hear is not mine, but the Father who sent me. These things I have spoken to you while being present with you. By the help of the Holy Spirit, who the Father, verse 26, will send in my name, he will teach you. Alright? That means that we lack the ability to know the word ourselves, even though we might be like a plant, a good Latin thing, a sabbath. But the ability to know the word of God only comes from God, and the Spirit of the Lord delivers that ability. Amen. No God, but we are reading English, the Pidgin, that's all. We will not know the word. The word is spirit. It is not physical, it's spiritual. So to know and get access into the spirit, we need a spiritual entity. We need the Holy Spirit. Neither person of the spirit will usher us into the spirit of the word, so that we will now grasp an understanding of the word of God. Amen. If it is just by natural understanding that we can understand, it's easy for the world to see. But the Bible says that the world will not receive, and they don't see. That means it's not natural now. It is supernatural. It's spiritual. Therefore, the Spirit will usher us into that area or dimension of the Spirit to know the Word, which is spiritual. That is the reason why the world has the Bible. They can write the Bible. They can quote scriptures. They can use it here, use it there, even place their hands on it and take an oath on it and whatever. But many of them do not believe the word, but they know the word carries authority. That's why they can put their hands on what is authority. But the Bible says you and me who knows God receives the Spirit and sees the Spirit. And in seeing the Spirit, we can see the Spirit of the Word. That's why when we see the Spirit of the Word, it's easy to keep the Word. Verse 24, he who does not love me does not keep my words, and the words which you hear, it's not mine but my Father. Verse 25, these things I have spoken to you while being present with you. By the help of the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things. I love it. And with the physical present on the new, I'm going to talk to you as I put to again. Now the body side, we might go. That's what can be some stuff of body in the presence is not here. Body, when we determine presence, is the body by go. But spirit will be by time so that the presence that was in the body that was with you will not leave. Even the body leaves, the presence will remain. You get me to the Garden of Eden, now you will know one thing. When God created the first man in chapter 2 of Genesis, I read through this and you know, he created what is the garden on the east called Eden. And that was the place that he placed men. Eden speaks about the presence of God. That moment, the presence. That's what it means. Support, presence, woman. God put the man on up, no Eden. And then God left. So in a way, Eden was like a partial or part of heaven. That God cut off from heaven, maybe creating and establishing the ground. And the man that he created, he put him in that place. Now what does it teach though? Me physically by me go. But presence through me, I will still live. The spirit comes, will maintain the presence for its continuity with you. So when God created Eden, he left. But the Eden, the presence of God that created man was there. So men continued to abide in the presence. Eden made the provision.
Oh yes.
God, Jesus said, I'm going to depart, but my spirit will make the provision for the continued presence of God to be always with you. Even though I'm gone, my presence will be with you. That's why he says, I shall abide with you forever. How and why? Because of the presence that doesn't leave. Amen. But man can get you why? Like you did? And we go. It depends on the choice that you make. You can get a divine knowledge of good and evil, the wisdom of the world. You can't be in the presence of God now, but you try not to try hard. The moment you go back and get a divine life, you maintain your position in Eden, in the presence. It's doing the will of the Lord, is eating from that tree, and you maintain the presence. The moment we start to get the wisdom of the world now, by the principles of the world, we cut ourselves off. Choose the right thing to do by doing the will. Freedom from the tree of life in Christ, and we stay there. You read all the way down, it's a promise of success and bearing of fruit in the next chapter. Good success is measured by our attachment to Christ, but that attachment also is determined by our love, by way of us doing the way. Amen? Good success, bearing good fruit, not a problem. God is a causing man to give boon, bearing fruit. There. I read to you the beginning of Psalm 29, calf keep. Oxen and skip like, serious, skip like a calf.
Oh, yes.
Bless when you see all place here. Excitement is more.
Amen.
What gives you excitement? Have you heard of the good news from afar? Hey, good news, breakthrough now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Woo-hoo-hoo. It's the voice of God that carries that ability and that grace that can retune the frequency of your life and my life to chase out all kind of dark clouds on it. You can now see hope. You can see light. You can see blessing. You can see breakthrough. And your song and my song will change. You listen up. God bless us. Papa, God, be the thank you, the powerful chest for you. The rhythm of the Lord shall say, I am. Hallelujah.